Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on how to build a 400 plus wheel horsepower BMW N55. Now, building a 400 plus wheel horsepower N55 is pretty simple. It really just boils down to a few simple bolt-on modifications and fueling, which we'll be discussing throughout this video. However, there is one important topic to discuss upfront when it comes to the BMW N55 before we jump into some of the best performance upgrades for the engine. Really, one big difference between some N55 engines is EWG versus PWG. So PWG stands for pneumatic wastegates, and this is found on most 2011 to 2013 model N55s. In 2014, BMW had switched to EWG, or electronic wastegate. What this really boils down to is wastegate control for the turbocharger, and the electronic wastegate on most 2014 plus models does have more precise control over the wastegates. The turbocharger is also ever so slightly larger on those later models with the EWG, again starting in 2014, and the downpipe is slightly bigger on the EWG models as well. But ultimately, what a lot of the difference boils down to is electronic wastegate control is much more precise, it has much better boost control, and is able to hold boost a lot better later in the RPM range. So basically what that leads to is the later 2014 plus EWG models are going to be a little bit more capable than the PWG models. So when we discuss some of these upgrades, the power gains for the PWG might be a little bit on the lower end, whereas the electronic wastegates or EWG models might be slightly on the higher end of these power ranges. Anyway, with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the best BMW N55 upgrades to build a 400 plus wheel horsepower engine. Number one on the list, we have tuning. Tuning is really going to be the best bang for your buck modification on the N55 and really the best starting point if you're just getting into modifications. Now, a tune alone can offer power gains in the ballpark of about 40 to 70 wheel horsepower. The exact gains really boil down to what stage or what map tune you are running. Something like a stage one is going to be slightly on the lower end. Something like a stage two or a stage one plus tune is going to be on the higher end of those 40 to 70 wheel horsepower gains. But nonetheless, incredibly impressive power gains for a simple $400 to $600 upgrade. Not only does it offer these incredible power gains, but a tune is also essential in maximizing power gains and performance benefits from the other bolt-on modifications that we'll be discussing throughout this video. When it comes to tuning options, the JB4 and MHD are going to be two of the more popular options. There's also Boot Mod 3, which is an incredibly popular option for the F chassis BMWs. However, the Boot Mod 3 tunes are not available for the E chassis N55. So something to keep in mind there. Ultimately, when it comes to picking the right tune, these are all great options. We'd recommend just doing a little bit of research, seeing which one really fits your goals and your budget and your wants. All great options. Can't really go wrong with any one of those tunes for the BMW N55. Moving on to upgrade number two to build a 400 plus wheel horsepower N55. We have an intake. An intake isn't going to be the most impressive when it comes to power and performance gains. You could expect to pick up roughly 3 to 7 wheel horsepower with an intake, maybe even give or take a couple depending on what tune you're running, what other modifications you're running. The stock N55 intake and airbox are relatively efficient at stock boost. However, the further you start pushing the engine, the more boost you start running, the more power you start running, that airbox starts becoming more and more restrictive. And so on a tune only engine with an intake, you might see power gains on the lower end of that ballpark, maybe 3 to 5 wheel horsepower. However, as you start increasing boost and power further and further, the gains from an intake start to become a little bit more impressive, and that's where you can see gains of maybe closer to 5 to 7 wheel horsepower, if not even a little bit more than that. However, an intake does also add some awesome turbo and induction sounds. Additionally, it's just a super cheap, simple, easy to install upgrade at $200 to $300. Hard to go wrong with an intake, and it's really a great upgrade to go ahead and combine with a tune. Combining those two is certainly a great starting point for the engine. Moving on to number three, we have downpipe upgrades for the BMW N55. Downpipe upgrades are going to offer power gains in the ballpark of roughly 10 to 20 wheel horsepower and about 15 to 25 wheel torque. So very impressive power and performance gains from a downpipe upgrade. With a downpipe, you'll also notice faster turbo spool. Additionally, reducing back pressure, which is the ultimate goal with the downpipe, is going to make the engine and the turbo's job a lot easier. It's ultimately just a lot safer and a lot healthier for the engine to reduce some back pressure with a downpipe upgrade. And then lastly, a downpipe is going to offer a louder, more aggressive exhaust note. Now, if you're just cruising around town or cruising on the highway, normal driving, a downpipe is really hard to notice. It's basically undetectable. You won't notice any droning or any obnoxious sounds. However, when you do a wide open throttle pull or on a cold start, it is going to sound a little bit louder, a little more aggressive, and you're going to hear a little more of the turbo spool. So it's kind of the best of the both worlds in the sense that a downpipe upgrade isn't going to be obnoxious or really even noticeable for normal daily driving. But when you do want to use the power, it is going to be a little bit louder and a little bit more aggressive. One important thing to distinguish between downpipe upgrades for the N55, you will find both catless and high flow catted downpipes. The ultimate goal with the downpipe upgrade is to reduce back pressure. A catless downpipe, as the name suggests, is going to completely remove the catalytic converter, which is going to lead to the greatest reduction in back pressure and ultimately the biggest power and performance gains. So a catless downpipe is going to be your best option for pure power gains. However, the downside with a catless downpipe, you likely won't pass any form of emissions testing, whether you have to hook up to an actual sniff test or even if it's just simple visual inspection. The mechanic inspecting your vehicle will notice the lack of the catalytic converters in a catless downpipe, and that will ultimately lead to an instant failure for any emissions or visual inspections. A high flow catted downpipe, on the other hand, shouldn't have any issues passing emissions testing or any visual inspections. So that's the real upside to a high flow catted downpipe. However, it does still have a high flow catalytic converter, so it doesn't reduce quite as much back pressure, so the power gains won't be quite as impressive. With the high flow catted downpipe, you'll probably be looking at gains slightly on the lower end of that spectrum, maybe 10, 12, 15 wheel horsepower. Whereas with the catless downpipe, you'll probably be looking at gains slightly on the higher end of that range, around that 17 to 20 wheel horsepower mark. Moving on to upgrade number four to build a 400 plus wheel horsepower N55. We have a front mount intercooler, or FMIC upgrade for short. A front mount intercooler can show power gains of about 5 to 10 wheel horsepower. However, really the biggest benefit of an intercooler upgrade is the fact that it's going to help keep intake air temperatures in check. So even after you do multi-gear back-to-back-to-back pulls, an upgraded intercooler is going to be able to prevent heat soak, keep those IATs in check. And so ultimately the biggest thing with an intercooler is going to be consistent performance. As opposed to the stock intercooler, if you start doing multi-gear pulls, especially back-to-back-to-back pulls, the engine is going to quickly heat soak, IATs will start skyrocketing, and ultimately the engine is going to start pulling some ignition timing, likely pulling out a little bit of boost, and that can basically lead to power loss of 10, 20 plus horsepower. With the intercooler, rather than the peak power gains, really the bigger benefit is the fact that you're going to notice that consistent performance time and time again. You won't run into those issues with heat soak and power loss. On top of that, keeping intake air temperatures a little bit lower, that is going to help reduce the chance of engine knock. So just a lot safer and healthier for the engine as well. Highly recommended, even though the peak power gains may not be quite as impressive as other modifications. It's really worth it just for the consistent performance and really keeping the engine a lot safer and healthier in general. One final note when it comes to intercoolers, you'll run across a lot of different sizes and a lot of different intercooler upgrades. A 5-inch intercooler is a good option if you're sticking with the stock turbocharger and don't have plans for an upgraded turbo in the near future. A 5-inch intercooler is going to be your best bet. Whereas if you're looking to upgrade your turbocharger in the future, then a larger 6.5-inch to 7.5-inch intercooler is likely a better option. Now, the reason for that is as you do start looking at larger and larger intercoolers, the volume and the core is going to be larger. So that does actually lead to a pressure drop after the turbo actually spools and compresses the air. Once it enters the intercooler, a larger core is going to cause that air to expand, and basically you'll start losing a little bit of pressure and the turbo spool will be a little bit slower. So on stock turbocharger, a 5-inch intercooler is plenty efficient. You don't really need anything larger. You don't need a bigger core, and that will help prevent these bigger pressure drops and slower turbo spool versus a bigger intercooler. Last but not least on our list here, upgrade number 5 for the BMW N55, we have an E85 blend, or specifically an E30 blend, or about 30% E85. E85, or ethanol fueling, has a very high octane rating. It's very knock resistant and it burns cooler than regular gasoline. All great benefits for the BMW N55 engine, especially since it is very octane hungry. It loves high octane fuel. So ethanol, even a small E30 blend, is going to make a drastic difference. With just an E30 blend, you can see power gains in the ballpark of about 10 to 25 wheel horsepower. So very impressive for an upgrade that's essentially free. If you do have easy access to E85, it's even cheaper than 91 or 93 octane, though it will reduce your fuel economy a little bit. So it's not really much cheaper than something like 91 or 93 octane in the grand scheme once you factor in the reduced fuel economy. It's a similar price to just normal gasoline, and you don't require any modifications or any upgrades on the N55 to run E30 fueling. Just select the appropriate map or the appropriate stage tune for E30 fueling, and that's all you need to do. So basically, if you have easy access to E85, this is essentially a free upgrade that can help net an extra 10, 20 wheel horsepower. And ultimately, it's a lot safer and healthier for the engine, mostly due to its superior knock resistance and high octane rating. That wraps up all of our power modifications for the N55 in this video. However, one thing worth mentioning is the charge pipe. The factory charge pipe is known to fail even at stock boost levels. So once you start tuning and modifying the engine, the chance of a charge pipe failure starts increasing drastically. With a tune, you might be okay with the stock charge pipe. However, once you start pushing past just a tune only and start adding additional upgrades like an intake, downpipe, intercooler, we would highly recommend addressing the charge pipe just to prevent the possibility of failure and leaving yourself stranded. So something to keep in mind there, it's not a power mod. You're not going to see any real power or performance gains from a charge pipe upgrade, but it does help with reliability and just ensuring that you don't run into that problem in the future once you begin tuning and modding your N55. In summary, the mods here, very simple: tune, intake, downpipe, intercooler, and then a small ethanol blend about E30 is all you really need to max out the N55 on the stock turbocharger. So as we mentioned at the start of the video, the PWG, the 2011 to 2013 models, are a little bit less capable with those pneumatic wastegates. With all of these bolt-on upgrades and fueling, you can expect the PWG models to max out around 380 to 400 wheel horsepower. And on the other hand, the more capable electronic wastegate or EWG models will max out closer to roughly that 410 to 430 wheel horsepower ballpark. Nonetheless, very impressive gains for the N55 with a couple simple bolt-ons. That wraps up our video for today, guys. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.